And the racing does go on. Barry Briggs is now retired, but his mantle's been taken up by the younger of his two sons, 18-year-old Tony, who's in his first year as a professional Speedway rider. Here at Hackney Stadium in London, Tony's being put through his paces by the man he wants to emulate. How's it going, Barry?
Oh, it's all right, Simon. He's a bit young for me, I think.
Because you don't ride at all now, do you?
No, very little. I just do a bit of practice with Tony here and there.
Yeah. Because, Tony, you're riding tonight here for your team Reading at Hackney. How do you fancy yourself?
Oh, the track looks lovely.
So have a sit down.
I'd do my best.
Yeah. You feel confident?
Oh, I think so. Everything's... fine on the bikes and that. So.
Right. Tony, the thing that everyone says when you have to follow a famous father is that you always have to live in his shadow, no matter what you do. And with Barry being one of the greatest names in Speedway, do you feel very conscious of that?
Not really, a little bit. When you're not going very well, people are always saying that you'll never be as good as your father. And when you're down, it affects you. But then I'm only giving my best anyhow, so... that's all I can do.
Right. How did you, in fact, turn professional? Was it something that you've always wanted to do, or was there a day when you thought, that's it, Speedway riding's the only thing?
Yeah, when I was at prep school, I had a little mini bike and that, and I always was dreaming as I was riding around the back garden of being a Speedway rider, and it's just something I've always wanted to do. I never became a specific date that I said I wanted to be a Speedway rider. I just always wanted to be it. And when I left school at 16, then I decided I wanted to definitely do it. Mm. And that's when we started.
Because, Barry, you've got two sons.
Yeah.
One's a year older than Tony. And he's a journalist, in fact, not a Speedway rider. Are you pleased about that?
Oh, you're very pleased, Simon. You know that I didn't really want Tony to be a Speedway rider. I can see the pitfalls in it. If you're very, very good, the rewards are great. But, you know, I sent them to the best school that I could afford. And... kept pushing tennis rackets and cricket bats in their hands, but that didn't seem to make much difference with Tony, but I'm happy that there's only one doing it. Mm.
Because you wouldn't have sent him to Millfield School, did you? That's if you right. thought he was going to become a Speedway rider, really?
I think you learn a lot at Millfield anyhow, besides anything else, you know, it's very sports-oriented, and I think it's like life, you win and lose just on a sports field, so... going to school, I wanted the best education that I could afford for them. And if he doesn't become a good spear rider within 2 or 3 years, then he's got something to fall back on. He's got a good education.
The day he told you, Dad, I want to follow you, I want to be a Speedway rider, were you pleased or did you try and discourage him?
Well, I never really did anything to encourage him at all, really. We rode motorcycles together. We enjoyed doing that. And when that time come, you know, we pointed out the dangers and what the bad things were about the game, and one of the lads that worked for me that was very close to Tony, Kevin Holden, got killed, so that, you know, Tony realised what he was going into. But when he said he wanted to do it, my idea, he had to do it absolutely as best that he can, as like a job, you know, there's no real glamour in it as such. And so he's buckled under, and for the first year I was really bad on him. I would yell and scream at him and had him in tears, basically to see that he really wanted to do it, because it's all very easy to just to take over Dad's workshop and Dad's motorcycles and everything else that goes with it. But, you know, it's about 15 months later now, so, and he's stuck to it. He's a good hard worker and he deserves to be a good rider, and I'm sure he wants to do it just on his own, nothing to do with me.
Mm. You mentioned the chap that was killed there, and also a fella from a club you rode for, Wimbledon, Tommy Jansen, he was killed. There's obviously a great deal of danger in the sport.
Oh, yeah, it is, and that's the worst part for me, because I feel for him. I can see him doing things that he shouldn't do, but I can't. Once he's pushed off, it's up to him. Mm. So the main thing you want, Simon, is, you know, he's been trained, he's a very well-trained spear rider for a very young boy, but he hasn't had any experience, but he needs luck. and you can't buy luck, or you can't even train for luck.
Because Barry, you lost a finger, didn't you, in an accident that we've seen earlier on, in the World Championship final. Do you not think that every time that Tony goes around to Benny, you're not at all worried that, you know, memories come flooding back?
Oh, yeah. There's been bad periods. I think at the moment it's not a bad period at the moment because he's a little bit smart and he doesn't go beyond his ability. But we've had the worst period. The first 6 months in America last year was always cartwheeling and all that. So you don't really know. When it's you laying on the ground, you know, hey, I think I broke my arm, or you become a doctor to yourself as you're laying there. But when he's laying down the other end of the track and I'm in the pits, I don't know, and I'm a worrier.
Yeah. Tony, they say that young people don't really feel fear the same way because they haven't really experienced the danger. Do you feel fear?
Oh, I don't think so, no. It's just what I enjoy doing, and I can't really say no, I don't think I do.
Are you a reckless person? I mean, do you drive a car? Do you drive that fast?
Gerald, right?
Not where my dad ran, no. No, I don't think so. I don't think so.
What is it about Speedway, apart from the fact that you know all about it, you've followed Barry around the world, what is it about it that appeals to you?
The main thing is really that I've played a lot of competitive sport and at a reasonable level, and I found the most enjoyment I got out of anything was riding my motorcycle. And if I can make my living at it, even better.
Yes. When you say make your living, Barry obviously made a fantastic living out of it. You're a wealthy family now. What is it about success that appeals to you? Is it the money that Barry's made? Is it the fame that he's got as well?
No, not really. It's knowing yourself that you're the best there is at your sport. You know, it's like a soccer player making England, really, isn't it? Mm. Getting into the England team.
But do things like, you know, a fancy house, a fancy car, a lot of money appeal to you?
I would think that appeals to everyone, really, but I haven't really thought about that side of it at all.
Are you dedicated?
Oh, yeah.
Is he?
Dedicated. Yeah, very, very good. Yeah, I can't fault him at all. As I say, the first year I did everything to make it bad for him, but he's put 101%, and if he doesn't make it at all, he's given it his best shot, and that's all I want of him, is to give it his best, and if it's not good enough, bad luck. Mm. He can move to something else, but he gives it 101%, and that's good enough for me, Simon.
What can you give to him as a sort of coach as well as a dad? Because surely it's a case of either you've got it or you haven't got it.
Well, I've given everything. I yell, I scream, I cuddle him, I kiss him, I do everything I think it requires at the right time. But the thing is, you need the experience you can't do anything about. And I see him do some dumb things, and once he's pushed off from the pit gates, I can't get to him. I went to Ipswich last week, and he's on number one start. I'm 5 yards from him, and he comes up there, and he's got no throttle on. I thought, he's in trouble. And I really should have walked over and said, turn some throttle on. But I thought, no, that'll look bad for the kid. I stood there, and he moved 6 inches, and the bike landed on top of him, just looped straight over him. And I say, why did you ever do that? Well, I saw John Lewis do. I said, but there's nothing in common. So he's got to have his own thoughts, and he'll never do that again. He won't look at another rider that's not on the similar machine or the similar weight and make the same mistake. I hope he does.
Are you tempted at all, Tony, to not to take Dad's advice, to say, no, this is the way I've seen someone else do that. I want to do that. I think Dad's wrong here.
No, I express my opinion. And
if
it's right or wrong, we discuss it there and then, you know. Mm.
The thing is, Simon, I've got to keep really fit, so every now and again I can jump back on the bike and beat him, you know.
Yeah.
That puts him in place for another couple of weeks.
No. Seriously, though, Barry, you say that you try to discourage him in a way, but you must be flattered because every dad, in a way, wants their son to emulate them. And here's a fellow who's followed you right the way through.
No, I don't believe that. I think most fathers and sons, the sons of fathers that have only been mediocre at something, then want to give their son of the best. Tony's got a terrible path to go behind me, and I would rather he doesn't try to do it. But he's made up his own mind, he's his own person, so it's up to him, and I'm 100% behind him. But I don't want any reflected glamour off him at all. I'd be quite happy today just Tony sitting here doing an interview.
They say, though, that in all sports, that a hungry fighter is the best fighter. Now, Tony, for all his virtues, he's never a hungry fighter, is he? You were. You came to England from New Zealand at the age of 17 with nothing, and you built it all up.
Yeah. Hunger doesn't actually mean hunger in the stomach. It's hungry for success as much as hungry for lack of food. And Tony, his mother says he's too much like me. He's temperamental and everything that you've got to be a spear rider. You can't be a dead nice person when you're racing for your living all the time. You've got to be hard but fair. You leave your opposition enough room to stay on his motorcycle and no more. And Tony has got that. Lots of times in normal life, I don't like it. You know, I think temperamental little so-and-so, but I accept it, you know. Whereas my other son is a really nice, placid boy in comparison. He has got a lot of riding ability, but he wouldn't be the best because of his attitude. But Tony has got the attitude, and it is a hungry attitude, although it's got nothing to do with food.
Do you feel hungry, Tony?
Yeah, actually, I'm.
But when you wake up in the morning and like tonight, you've got a meeting on. Do you feel really nervous? Very keyed up every day you're performing.
Yeah, I try not to get nervous, but obviously you do. And I definitely want to do it. You know, win as much as I can.
What about the cynics who say that if you make it, you'll just be Barry Briggs' son? Well, he had every chance. He's got the best gear, he's got the best bike. I mean, how could he possibly fail? And if you do fail, they say, well, how pathetic. You know, there he is, Barry Briggs' son. He couldn't make it. Do you feel conscious of that?
No, not really. Not really. He can't turn the throttle on for me out there. You know, he can't turn the corner for me. So it's down to me, really, isn't it?
What do you think you need to make the top? What sort of qualities? I mean, is it the lack of fear? Instinctive qualities?
Oh, it's very, very difficult to say, really.
Work.
How hard do you
work? And dedication, that's the main thing.
You work pretty hard, don't you? Because you go in the garage, you wake up, you're working every day.
Yeah, just about. And then I go training in the afternoons and on and off. Mm.
Things haven't worked too well, though, have they? Haven't started off too well here. I mean, you've had a fairly disappointing time. Is that easy to live with?
It wasn't very enjoyable. but I hope we've got over that now. And I think it's got to get better.
What can you do in that sort of situation, Barry? I know you're in America a lot, but do you ring him up a lot?
Yeah, I'm. You know, we're constantly on the phone as such. But you know, we started off the season. He did doing fairly well for what he was jumping into. But when I went away, everything somersaulted. And sometimes he's like a 25-year-old, and sometimes he's like a 14-year-old. And we had a couple of phone calls from him that he was very, very upset. And I had special things to do in America, so I couldn't come back. But since we've been back, we found out that a lot of the trouble has been his motorcycles, and he was over trying. And last Monday at Reading, he had a very, very good meeting. He's very, very slow on the start, which is one of the most important parts, as we heard, but he was passing and getting up to the front in most races. So I think the tide has turned there, but it's going to take time, and that's what we've always said when everyone asks this question. The main thing is to give the kid a bit of time.
Mm. One thing I know viewers at home watching this are going to say, there's a sense of a mum being squeezed out here. How does mum fit into all this?
Oh, mum got all the grey hair through me. And
what did she say when Tony said, I'm turning professional?
She was going to, she was kind of expecting and hoping against us. But probably the best thing is that she's not really too close to Tony at this period of time when things are not going well, because you have a one-track mind, and mothers and fathers, if they just live a normal life, expect their son to come home and eat their meals on time and do things regulated, whereas, you know, in this situation and this type of living, you're a bit like a gypsy, and you're not the best son as a son at that period anyhow. Mm.
Tony, they say that you are going to make the top three in the world within the next 3 years. That's a hell of a thing to live up to, as well as being his son. Can you make that?
I hope so. You know, that's what we're heading for. And that was really the aim we set ourselves. No one really set it for us.
Do you think he can, Barry?
Oh, yeah, definitely. If I didn't think he could do it, we wouldn't be spending so much time and effort. And it's luck. We've got to have the luck, but he can do it.